store for music and dancing. There's two things that we wanted to cover. Thinking about tonight's moment and what we're doing, this morning I happened to talk to an author of four books, and I had seen something in the Chief of Police magazine, which he contributes to. Vince Covey, he used to belong to Assumption Church, but a very, very competent person. He talks to the police chiefs and so forth. And I know that he had written an article, Reawakening the Nation. And as he was talking to the police and so forth, I noticed that 155 federal, state, and tribal and local law enforcement officers had died this year alone, as of June 30th, so a half a year. And it struck me that if I could basically just read the prayer that he had written for America and for the police. You each hopefully have something at your table. If you don't, raise your hand and one of our Mary Queen of All Nations will pass to you. And all I'm going to do is take the time to read it at a moment to just reflect on all that we're talking about. It's a time for Thanksgiving. It's a time to thank all those that have passed, including these 155 law enforcement officials. And may you continue to help all those that are existing, whether it be those that come back with PTSD from the war, or whether it be the police or the fire that don't remember where they happened to kiss their child or their family, but at great risk, they're here defending us. And basically the picture behind me depicts an eagle. And basically it's supposed to suggest to you that freedoms aren't free and that vigilance is required. So now I'm going to read the prayer. I hope I do it justice. Vincent isn't here, but I have his permission. I'm going to put all my glasses. A prayer for America. Almighty God, enkindle us to be radiant light so darkness can be vanquished and our communities reawakened. Let us live by the splendor of truth and high ethical standards so deception can be eradicated from our nation. Give us an unwavering confidence in our task and keep the torch of character burning in our hearts. Forge partnerships between all members of our community. Let apathy be conquered and inspire us to exemplify respect, courtesy, and charity. Allow the providential wisdom of our American heritage to guide us. Empower us with unfailing strength to bear all trials. Enlighten us so this unique time of challenge may impel us to transform the nation. Protect each person privileged to call America home with the ironclad shield of virtue and the shelter of justice. Ignite wisdom, understanding, and compassion within our souls. Animate our hearts so we may work with one another and live in a nation of tranquility, solidarity, and liberty. Amen. And I thank Vincent for giving me the privilege of reading his special prayer. I hope that you will put it in your booklet as part of the program tonight. And I hope it captures the sense of everyone in the room respecting those that have gone before us, and that as we go before, we work with each other hand in glove. Thank you. And at this point in time, I'm going to ask Emerson, a Marine who fought in Vietnam, if he might share a little song or two. Emerson?
Yes. We got the Gunny's here, so good evening should be louder than that. Good evening. You know, after listening to the Gunny and then thinking about the event this evening and realizing that it's such a labor of love with the Cruz family and my good friend here, who put this together, and then I hear the Gunny talking about the love that Marines have for one another, that we're prepared to sacrifice our lives for each other. I decided to sing a song that I don't even know. So because it's all about love. And if you know the song, you can join in. All right, sing the song. Let's get together and feel alright. One love, one heart. Give thanks and praise to the Lord, and I will feel alright. Let's get together and feel alright. Let them all pass all their dirty remarks. There is one question I really like to ask. Is there a place for that hopeless sinner who has hurt all mankind just to save his own life? One love, see it with me. One heart. Let's get together and feel alright. One love, one heart. Give thanks and praise to the Lord, and I will feel alright. Yeah, listen to this part. Feel alright. Let's get together to fight this holy Armageddon. So when the man comes, there will be no doom. Let's help him. Those chances are fading. There's no hiding place from the Father of creation. Come on. Get together and feel alright. One love, one heart. Give thanks and praise to the Lord, and thou wilt feel alright. Let's get together and feel alright. I used to think that love was just a fairy tale, until that first hello, till that first smile. But if I had to do it all again, I wouldn't change a thing, 'cause this love is everlasting. To me,
we're on track.
There's beauty up above, things we never take notice of. You wake up and suddenly you're in love. Everything a man could want and more. 1,000 words are not enough to say what I feel inside. Holding hands as we walk on the shore, I never felt like this before. Now you're all I'm living for. Suddenly, life has new meaning to me. There's beauty up above, things we never take notice of. You wake up and suddenly you're in love.
last forever. Ooh, suddenly, life has new meaning to me. There's beauty above, things we never take notice of. You wake up and suddenly you're